दक्षिणामूर्ति स्तोत्रम वर्स नंबर 6 चैंट टुगेदर
राहु ग्रस्त दिवाकरे तु सदृशो
Shankaracharya is a great acharya who brings the great Advaita Vedanta in the form of a stotram, Dakshinamurti stotram. Stotram means stuti only. Glorification, praising. He is praising the Paramatma, the Lord, who is in Saguna form as Dakshinamurti. At the same time, he is bringing that the great teaching Nirguna Brahma Vidya through Dakshinamurti. Therefore, this Dakshinamurti Stotram is very popular throughout India. Some prayers are popular in North India, some prayers are popular in South India, but this Dakshinamurti Stotram is very popular because of its unique teaching. All these bhaktas, devotees also chant Dakshinamurti Stotram. And Vedantic acharyas are also, they focus on this subject because the highest teaching is hidden in every line of this verse. So for punya's sake, one can chant Dakshinamurti Stotram. For knowledge sake also, one can study the stotra, the word, meaning. So both are possible, bhukti and mukti. Bhukti means materialistic benefit, some punyam. Mukti means moksha. These both benefits one can derive from this Dakshinamurti stotra. Apart from this, nowadays, because of some astrologers telling, you require Guru Balam, you require lot of Guru Balam. Therefore, even in villages, many towns, everywhere, people are worshipping Dakshinamurti on Thursdays in Guruvar, because it is Guru. Dakshinamurti is a guru. Therefore, people worship specially on that day, Thursday. You require Guru Balam. For materialistic prosperity also, you require Guru Balam. For Brahma Vidya also, you require Guru Balam, Guru Anugraha. Either way, you see, these verses are all very, very unique and very important. We should not take it as just stotram, but you see the depth of each line and word. Mandukya Upanishad, Chandogya Upanishad, Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, all Upanishads teaching is presented here. What is that teaching? Tatu Tvam Asi, you are Brahman. You are Brahman, when Guru says, first I have to know who am I. For that Guru says, my dear student, you means Panchakosha Vilakshana Atma. You are different from all the five koshas. Shariratraya Vilakshana Atma. You are different from all the three bodies. Three bodies are only bifurcated into five koshas. Not only that, you are different from all Nama Rupa Prapancha. You are the Adhishtanam of this entire universe. But why I am not able to know such a unique, great nature of mine? What is the reason? Reason is nothing but you are not exposed to that your real nature through proper study. Because of ajnana, your swarupam is as though concealed. Because of ajnana, maya. In this sixth verse he says, just as the Rahu is concealing that Surya Prakasha and Chandra Prakasha, Rahu Grasta, that Rahu who catches or who covers, conceal on eclipse day, Grahanam day, the Rahu covers or conceal Divakara Indu. Surya, Divakara, Indu, the sun, both are concealed. Every year comes, it seems. Every year one type of eclipse, in 12 years another type of eclipse. So this is what we are seeing. Concealment like that, sadrishaha. Like that here also. Maya samachadanat, because of maya, prakriti. Maya samachadanat. It is as though covered. That as though you have to put. Really it cannot cover, really it cannot conceal. Because of bhranti, because of superimposition, because of adhyasa, or because of ignorance, this is as though covered. Temporarily, until you get jnanam, it is temporarily as though covered. At that time you cannot know. The shadow of this Rahu, the Rahu is nothing but the earth shadow. That earth shadow, when earth is moving, the shadow of the earth comes in between Surya and the earth. When the earth is moving on its own, the shadow of the earth is called Rahu or Ketu, whatever you call. That shadow, as though it conceals. What happens to that sun or moon at that time? Really speaking, nothing happened. Sun is as it is, moon is also as it is. But our perception, our vision is concealed, not able to see that because of some movement of that earth. We know that it is not really concealment. On the other hand, that shadow is come to know through sunlight only. that shadow you come to see because of moonlight or sunlight. You can see that small line also, it even full eclipse, that time you can see the line of that sun or moon. Completely as though covered, like that here also. Because of avidya, because of ajnanam, you do not know that you are atmaswarupam. Especially in jagrat and swapna. Because your sense organs are active. In sleep, deep in dream, they are partially active. In jagrat, they are highly active. Maya is playing her role at that time, jagrat and swapna. At that time, you cannot grasp really as though it is eclipse. Jagratavastha and swapnavastha as though eclipse-like. Because our sense organs dragged towards nama, rupa, external objects. They go outside only all the time. Mind also goes outside. At that time you cannot recognize that. Therefore, Bhagavan has given another state other than waking state and dream state, that is sleep state, that is given in second line. At that time you remain as you are, sanmatraha karanaha. In jagrat and wake dream state you cannot grasp that much easily. Therefore, try to understand about your sleep, what is happening there. Study about your sleep, that you understand your real nature. The same Atmaswarupam you can understand in jagrat and swapna also. How? When that indriyas, sense organs of action, sense organs of knowledge, karana upasamharataha. When you are sushuptaha puman, when you are a sleeper, when you are a sleeper, sushuptaha aham puman, jivatma, the individual, when he is sleeping, yaha karana upasamharataha abhut. When he became passive in his sleep without using the mind sense organs. Upasamharanataha abhu. Karana upasamharana. Karana means sense organ, upasamhara means withdrawal. Abhut. All you have became like that only night, all of us. And morning we have woken up. Every day. Karana upasamharana daha aham bhavami. Every day. Sometimes in class also, some people, not early morning class. Some classes, sometime when you are tired, your sense organs withdraws. At that time, who is there? Sanmatraha. At that time, your existence is available. Your existence, sanmatraha means sat alone, is available because no nama, rupa, jnanam. Karma is also not there, jnanam is also not there, because sense organs are all taking rest because of tiredness. He is sleeping. Karana upasamharana taha yaha sushuptaha puman abhut sanmatraha. At that time, every one of us, they all go to hridayam. Chandogya Upanishad, it is elaborated. When at the time of sleep, all sense organs go to the hridayam and they take rest there. at that time pure consciousness existence principle alone is available. That means in Mandukya language you are neither Vishwa means nor wake, you are not waker, you are not a dreamer also. In Gadha Nidra you are only a sleeper. That means you are a prajna at that time. Then what happens in deep sleep you do not know, but Shastra Pramanam is there. Shastra says through Shastra you understand. My dear, after waking up what you are telling, tell me. Shastra is asking. That comes in the third line. What is that? The third line says aham asvapsam iti. I slept well in the night sleep. Aham asvapsam. Two experiences you reveal after waking up. Once you become a waker, after waking up, you become a Vishwa. As a Vishwa, you reveal two statements. Statement number one is, I slept well. Aham sukham asvapsam. That old word is not used from the Upanishad. Asvapsam word only used in Chandogya. Sata somya sada sampanno bhavati. That time, oh my dear Sishya, this Jivatma merges with Paramatma, Atmaswarupam. Because I am Karanam, Karyam, Bhagavan is Karanam, Jiva is the Karyam. So Jiva merges into Karanam. Just as ornament merges into gold, similarly at the time of sleep, you the Jivatma, the Karyam, the product, merges with your own cause, that is Paramatma. This is the logic. Karyam has to merge with Karanam. Therefore, I the Karyam Jivatma, Karya Jivatma, merges into my real nature, Karana Paramatma. That is the idea presented here. What form that Karana Paramatma is then? Pure existence and consciousness. Pure existence and consciousness I merge with my own nature, that is Karana Atma. How I reveal that? First statement, I slept well, number one. Number two, I don't know anything. I did not know anything in the night. Two statements you reveal many times. Every one of us, I slept well. Number one, statement number one. Statement number two, I did not know anything in the sleep yesterday night. I know that I did not know anything in my sleep. These two statements we all express one time or other in our Vishwa as a waker, when I wake up. Correct? Is it true or not? Are you having any doubt with regard to these two statements? Who is doing these two statements? I myself, the waker. I myself, the waker, after waking up from my sleep, I talk about my own experience in the night, what happened. I slept well, I did not know anything. That I know. I know I slept well. How can you make that statement without your knowledge? I know that I slept well, and I know I did not know anything. You have to think a lot. Casually we do statements, but we never think. That is the problem for us. Teacher makes us to think. What is the teacher's job? Teacher's job is only to make us to think. I am not talking any new thing. Upanishad is also not telling any new thing, but Upanishad is telling that what you know, please analyze that. What you are making the statements after waking up, without exception, every one of us, we are doing that statements. I slept well. Statement number one. I did not know anything. Statement number two. As a pragna, I cannot make these statements. As a sleeper, can I make these statements, two statements? When you are doing these two statements, after waking up, I slept well. Nanna thoongina. Tamil la solanavana enna solanum? Nanna thoongina, enakku onnume theriyadhu. Aha. Enna language la sonnalum idhe statement da. Anybody, any language, they talk, these two statements only. That is why Acharya presents here asvapsam iti. That asvapsam within inverted commas. These are the statements said by this waker, Vishvaha. How, in what way? Pratyabhijñāyate. Third line, last word. Pratyabhijñāyate. He recognizes, he recollects. Pratyabhijñā means recollection. This waker, I am recollecting my yesterday night experience. When you are telling to other person, you are recollecting. What you are recollecting? I slept well. Statement number one, you are recollecting. Now you are not sleeping, but you are recollecting your sleep, yesterday's night sleep. I slept well. I did not know anything. Now you are recollecting. And you are sharing that with other person. Correct? Is this a new teaching? This is very, very evident, known to us. I slept well. I did not know anything. Pratyavijna. This is called recollection. When can you do recollection? Next statement. Next question. When you do recollection? When you collect only, you can recollect. When you cognize only, you can recognize. Correct? Without cognition, you can recognize. Without collection, you cannot recollect. Pratyabhijna means recognition or recollection. I recollect my past experience now after waking. Correct? Yaha pratyabhijñāyate. Whoever is recollecting, I slept well, I did not know anything. Whoever is recollecting, yaha pratyabhijñāyate. Who is that recollecting? I am only. I the waker. Everyone has to say to oneself, I the waker alone, I am recollecting, recognizing about my two experiences. I reveal after waking. What are those two experiences? Asvapsam, aham sukham asvapsam. I slept well. Na kinchit avedesham. I do not know anything. I did not know anything because it is past tense. 6 hours back. I did not know anything. If you say early morning, it is 6 hours back. If you say in the evening, it is 24 hours back. Like that you have to say. I did not know anything. Na kinchit avedesham. And the translation of I did not know anything. These two statements you have to put in within inverted commas. What are they? Aham sukham asvapsam. What is the translation? I slept well. Statement number one. So that second statement, Upanishad says, na kinchit avedesham. Translation, I did not know anything. Translation. Now, question is, pratyabhijna means, I know that. Now, I recollect, I recognize. I know that I slept well. I know that I did not know anything. Who is this I know? I know, how do you know? The question comes. For that Shastra says, in Prajna Avastha, sleep Avastha, you are in Karana Avastha. At that point, I left in the last class. Okay? Karana Vritti, I said. Karana Vritti or in Prajna Avastha, I am as a sleeper, I am in Karana Shariram. In that Karana Shariram, the Karana Vritti rise. That Karana Vritti is called Sukshma Vritti. That Sukshma Vritti is known as Avidya Vritti. I know my ignorance. I did not know anything means what? I am ignorant at that time. That is the meaning. Na kinchid avedisham. I did not know anything means I know I am ignorant. Correct? I know that I was ignorant in my sleep. That is why it is called avidya vritti. I know that I did not know anything. Now I am telling. But at that time, total ignorance. Is it shunyam? No. I am in Karana Vritti registering all those two experiences. If they are not registered through Karana Vritti, I would have not got this Pratyabhijna. That is very crucial point. ஒன்றுமே இல்லைன்னு சொல்ல முடியாது தூக்கத்தில். ஐ ஆம் சன் மாத்ரஹா, ஐ ஆம் யோர் எக்ஸிஸ்டன்ஸ் கான்ஷியஸ்னஸ் பிரின்சிபல், ஐ ஆம் தேர் இன் ஸ்லீப். ஐ ஹவ் ரிஜிஸ்டர்ட் மை எக்ஸ்பீரியன்சஸ். ஐ ஸ்லெப்ட் வெல், தட் சுகம், நித்ரா சுகம், ஐ ஹவ் ரிஜிஸ்டர்ட். And ignorance, I do not know anything because sense organs are not functioning. No knowledge is available there. Therefore, I did not know anything. Second thought registered in Karana Vritti, Sukshma Vritti, Avidya Vritti, thought form, they are registered. And the registered thought, I slept well, I did not know, registered, you cannot talk about them, the two experiences. To talk about, you require sthula shariram, sukshma shariram. Once you wake up, sthula shariram is available. Therefore, you are able to talk about that and your mind is available. You recognize, you recollect the past experience. Correct? Are you getting the point? How great verse it is, you see. Now sanmatraha karana upasamharanataha yaha sushuptaha puman prag asvapsam. Prag means what? Prabodha samaye prag, he was experiencing in sleep. Before, at the time of sleep, now this person has woken up. Now he is telling, in my sleep, prag, but asvapsam, before this waking state, I slept well, I did not know anything. Prag asvapsam iti prabodhasamaye, at the time of waking only, after becoming a waker, prabodhasamaye, at the time of 5 o'clock or 4 o'clock, that is called prabodhasamayam, waking time. Once you wake up, you become a waker. In Sanskrit, what is the name for waker? Vishvaha. I become a Vishvaha. And I express. Prabodha samaye yaha puman Vishvaha prityabhijnayate. He recollects. He remembers. He recognizes. Every one of us sleeping, every one of us expressing these two statements, but we never think without the shloka study. Can you understand all these words? Pratyavigna, I slept well, I did not know anything. These are all registered in Karana Vritti. I was Prajna in sleep. Now I am a waker. All this you can get without studying Dakshinamurti Stotra. Tell me, our Upanishads. You have to study. Now, Vedanta is a study about something else or about yourself. Tell me now. Upanishadic teaching or Dakshinamurti Stotra is talking about something else which is not relevant to me, or it is talking about something which is very much relevant to me. You decide now. Now you decide. Whenever you come to the class, you are studying about your physical body, your subtle body, your causal body, your pure existence, consciousness, nature, you are studying. And your relation with the world, you are studying. We are not teaching anything other than this in Vedanta class. Unfortunately, people think Vedanta means ennamo, enna ennamo. Hey, Vedanta class is a study about yourself, who you are. You are mixed with gross body, subtle body, causal body, and consciousness existence. Are you not interested in studying about yourself? And skipping this knowledge and studying about everything. Who is studying everything? They are not studying about that who. Who? WHO who? Enna? Eppadi patta padippu? Nee yaarenu therinjikamale nee ellame padichindirukke. That is why unrest in the world. நீ யாருன்னு தெரிஞ்சுக்கோ, தெரிஞ்சுகிட்டே நீங்கள் படிக்கலாம். தட் இஸ் வெரி இம்பார்ட்டண்ட். அதர்வைஸ் தட் அபரா வித்யா பிகம் மீனிங்லெஸ், பர்பஸ்லெஸ், யூஸ்லெஸ் அண்ட் இட் பிகம்ஸ் எ பர்டன் டு யூ. வை யூ ஹாவ் டு ஸ்டடி அபவுட் திஸ் ஹூ ஆம் ஐ? டு மேக் யுவர் லைஃப் மோர் மீனிங்ஃபுல், பர்பஸ்ஃபுல், வித் தட் அபரா வித்யா யூ கேன் என்ஜாய் மோர். Once you study about all these five, what are the five? Satchit, Chidabhasa, Diji, Ahankara and Sthura Shariram, Sushma Shariram, Karana Shariram. In the anji vittittu ennamo pandrana, odi odi jnana tangame thedugindrane nu solra shastram. Thedugindrane engengiyo odi odi pora, adi pannanum idi pannanum. This is the meaning of this shloka. The one who teaches this, Dakshinamurti is talking about this. Prityavignayate yaha prabodha samaye asvapsamiti prityavignayate. What he has registered in the sleep time, sushuptaha puman upakarana samharata karana upasamharataha. What a verse, one verse is sufficient, whole Vedanta is over. Purunja, whole Vedanta is over. Therefore, who am I now? I am Sanmatraha. When can you grasp this? When can you recognize this? Not in sleep. You cannot say, I am Brahmasmi. Sollamudiyuma Jnanam Varuma in sleep. I did not know anything in sleep. How can I claim I am Brahman? Shastra gives a clue. My dear, study about the sleep and claim that you are Sanmatraha in waking also. Same Satchit only I am in waking as a waker and as a dreamer also. There is no change in that. How to understand? For that next verse, How can I claim that that sanmatra alone is myself? The doubt comes. இதுவரைக்கும் ரொம்ப நல்லா இருக்க சுவாமினி, எவ்ரி திங் இஸ் நைஸ் இன் வேக்கிங் அண்ட் ட்ரீம் ஸ்டேட். மாயா கவர்ஸ் அஸ், கன்சீல்ஸ் அஸ், அண்ட் வென் ஐ கோ டு ஸ்லீப் ஆல் சென்ஸ் ஆர் கான்ஸ் ஆர் நாட் ஃபங்க்ஷனிங். அட் தட் டைம் காரண விரத்தி இஸ் ரிஸ்டரிங். தட் காரண விரத்தி இஸ் ஹேப்பனிங் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் சத் அண்ட் சித். தட் கான்ஷியஸ்னஸ் இஸ் அவைலபிள் தேர், அவேர்னஸ் இஸ் தேர். Because of that only I am knowing. That I am registered two statements I am revealing after waking. Who is teaching? This is called Dakshinamurti. My salutations to him. Nanna irukke kekkuradhu. But how do I know this sat and chit alone is my nature? How do I know? How can I accept? How can I claim? For that, Shankaracharya says, whatever is changing is not you. Whatever is not changing, that is you. He is presenting in a beautiful manner. In the next verse, we will read that verse, seventh verse, together.
बाल्यादिष्वपि जाग्रदादिषु तथा सर्वास्वस्थास्वपि व्यावृत्तास्वनुवर्तमानमहमित्यं तस्फुरन्तं सदा स्वात्मानं प्रकटीकरो
this sat and chit consciousness and existence principle is always inheres in three avasthas: ஜாகிரத அவஸ்தா, ஸ்வப்னாவஸ்தா அண்ட் சுஷுப்தி அவஸ்தா. ஸ்லீப்பர் இஸ் நாட் தேர் இன் வேக்கர். ஸ்லீப்பர் எக்ஸ்க்ளூட்ஸ் த வேக்கர். வேக்கர் எக்ஸ்க்ளூட்ஸ் த ட்ரீமர். ட்ரீமர் எக்ஸ்க்ளூட்ஸ் த வேக்கர் அண்ட் ஸ்லீப்பர். வேக்கர் எக்ஸ்க்ளூட்ஸ் த ஸ்லீப்பர் அண்ட் ட்ரீமர். Sleeper excludes the dreamer and waker. What is this? That means, when I am sleeping, I am not a waker, I am not a dreamer. When I am a waker now, are you a waker or not now? Now, in this class, 7:36 minutes, are you a waker or not? Are you in a waking state? Therefore, you are a waker. You are waker. In this waker, you are not sleeping now. I hope so. You are not sleeping. That means you are not a sleeper. Sleeper excluded. You, the waker, excluded whom? The sleeper. Then you have excluded the dreamer also, because you are not dreaming now. To dream, you require sleep. Since you are not a sleeper, You cannot be a dreamer. That means you have excluded dreamerhood. You are waker. You are neither dreamer nor sleeper. Yesterday night in Gadha Nidra sleeper time you were not waker also, dreamer also. While you were dreaming at that time, you were not sleeper also, waker also. Each avastha excludes the other. Correct? Is it clear? Very, very clear. This is one type of presentation that comes first line, second half. First line, first half, he says, balya adishu, balya. When you are a child, baby, balya. Adipadat, when you are in yavanam, youth. When you are old, at all stages, this I is the same, naan, naan. My childhood, my youth, my old age, you say. I was a boy, I was a boy or a girl before 10 years, balyavastha. Then from teenage onwards, kishoravastha. 13 years to 19 years, kishoravastha. When I was in teenage, when I was in teenage. Now nobody is in teenage here, that's why I was, I am using. Correct? When I was in teenage. So you are a youth, in my youth now, you can say, suppose you are above 50, you can say, now in my old age, I am in old age, I was, when I was in youth, when I was in my young age, when I was in my childhood, I is common. But childhood is not there in youth. Youthhood is not there in old age. Old age is excluding youth. Youth is excluding childhood. Childhood is excluding youth. Youth is excluding childhood and old age. Childhood excluding youth and old age. Each avastha, balyavastha, yavanavastha, Kaumaravastha, Yavanavastha, Vriddhavastha. How many avasthas are there? Jagrat, Swapna, Sushupti, three avasthas. From the standpoint of gross body, subtle body and causal body. Another classification, only physical body if you take. Avastha level, three bodies are working. If you take youth, childhood, old age, connected to subtle body, causal body or gross body? Gross body. So my own gross body going through balyavastha, yavanavastha or kishoravastha, yavanavastha, vriddhavastha. That's why kumaravastha is called kaumaravastha. Kaumaravastha is called teenage, between 13 and 19. So who is there continuously? Balyavastha is not in Kaumaravastha, Kaumaravastha is not in Yavanavastha, Yavanavastha is not there in Vriddhavastha. But I am there in all avasthas. Avastha pattin irukken. Okay. I that continues. All these are vyavrittam. All these avasthas are vyavrittam, means excludes each other. Anuvrittam is what? I am. I continues. I was alone boy, I was alone youth, I am alone is old now. This I is not changing. I is changing? Naan angal change agarada illiye adida anuvrittam in years anusyotataya vartate naan angarade anusyotataya vartate in years anuvrittasu vyavritte anuvrittam which is vyavrittam which is anuvrittam tell me now that which is continuing is anuvrittam that which is not continuing is vyavrittam Balyavastha is not continuing, therefore vyavrittam. Yavanavastha is not continuing throughout life, therefore vyavrittam. Vriddhavastha also not continuing. After some time this avastha also goes away. In Balyavastha, Vriddhavastha is not there, therefore it is not continuous. They have a period of time, a period of time, a period of time. But I am, who is experiencing Balyavastha, who is experiencing yavanavastha, who is experiencing vriddhavastha, I am same person or not? I am same. Therefore, balyadishvapi jagradadishu tatha sarvasu avasthasvapi vyavrittasu anuvartamanamaham iti aham anuvartaman. I am continuously there where balya adishu, balya yavana vriddhavastasu, jagrada adishu, jagrat sopna sushuptishu, I am there. Then sarvasu avasthasvapi, sarvasu, in all experiences, I am is safe. Sarvasu avasthasu, tatha sarvasu avasthasvapi. Motherhood, fatherhood, brotherhood, sisterhood, all hoods are changing. One hood is coming and going. But I, that is the third line. Swatmanam prakatikaroti bhajatam yo mudraya bhadraya. Dakshinamurti is one. Through his bhadraya mudraya, what bhadram? Bhadra means mangalam. Mudra means a sign, chin mudra. Here mudraya means chin mudraya. Through his chin mudra, dakshina murti, with an auspicious mudra, bhajatam, those who come to Sunday morning dakshina murti stotram class, those who want to do shastra study, shravanam, for them bhajatam bhadraya mudraya, with his chin mudra, swatmanam prakati karoti, he reveals his real nature. Dakshina murti reveals his real nature. Swatmanam prakati karoti, what is the real nature? Sat and chit. What is the speciality of this mudra? You know, many times now I have to explain, all these three fingers are Kanishthika, Anamika, Madhyama. All these are Strilingam. This is Pumlingam, Angushtha Matra Purushaha Atma. Three Sharirams. When the Jivatma dissociate and come and bend with Chin Mudra, it becomes with the thumb. Ahankara RC is false. I am, that thought is rising in the mind. In that mind, it is because of Jada Vritti, Jada Manaha gets that I am, that sentiency, the thought, because of Chidabhasa. That Chidabhasa is because of Chit, Angushtha Matra Purusha. By approaching a guru doing Namaskara, bending Namaskara, studying Shastra, attending sadhana camps, there also what we do, the same thing. I dissociate, guru helps me to dissociate with this anatma, three shariraṁs, three avasthas, sthula, sukshma, karana, shariraṁs, you are not. Jagrat, svapna, sushupti, three avasthas, you are not. Sattva, rajas, tamo, gunas, gunatrayam, shariratrayam, avasthatrayam, I am not. Who will teach? My guru will teach. Dakshinamurti. Like my guru is sitting here and teaching, who is none other than Dakshinamurti. Swatmanam prakati karoti. He reveals his nature. Sishya's nature also Atma, and Guru's nature is also Atma. Paramatma nature is also Atma. Sat Chitti alone. Bodies will come and go. Avasthas will come and go. And gunas will come and go, but I, the pure existence consciousness, will never come and go. I am intertwined in them, at the same time I am not touched by them. Yaha prakati karoti tasmai. to such a guru, Dakshinamurti, my salutations. Looking to the verse now, Balyadishvapi Jagradadishu Adipadat Balya means Yavana, Kaumara, Yavana, Vrutha. Jagradadishu, Jagrad Swapna Sushupti. Tatha, like that, Sarvasu Avasthasu. Any Avastha, that means wifehood, brotherhood, fatherhood, motherhood, any hood for that matter, any role what you play is Vesham. I am Veshi. I am putting a Vesham. Vesham is real or Veshi is real? And the word of the Sulimam, the one who puts costume, that person is real or costume is real? Person is real. Costume is not real. Motherhood is a costume. Childhood is a costume. Fatherhood is a costume. Employee is a costume. Officer is a costume. Teacherhood is a costume. Studenthood is a costume. All are costumes. Vesham. But I, the pure awareness, consciousness, existence, principle, aham, aham, I am not a costume. I am a Veshi, the person. Balyadishvapi jagradadishu tatha sarvasu avasthasu abhi vyavruttasu anuvartamana. Even though in the changing in all of them, I am anuvartamana. How do you say that? Aham, aham, aham iti. Naan, naan, naan ani solindirukom. Naan vandu wife, naan vandu husband, naan vandu employee. Andha naan angiradhu da anuvrittam. Correct? எத்தனை நாளை படிச்சுட்டு இருக்கோம் இந்த ஸ்லோகம். ஹவு மெனி இயர்ஸ் வி ஆர் சாண்டிங். டுடே ஓன்லி வி கம் டு நோ த மீனிங். இந்த அளவுக்கு ப்ரிப்பரேஷன் பண்ணணும். பகவத்கீதா உபனிஷத்து சொல்லி சொல்லி அதுக்கப்புறம்தான் இது இந்த ஸ்லோகம் புரியும். தட்ஸ் வை சாண்டிங் இஸ் ஆல்சோ ரிக்வயர்ட். அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங் த மீனிங் இஸ் ஆல்சோ ரிக்வயர்ட். ஐ ஆம் continuously there in childhood, youth and old age. I am continuously there in Jagrat, Swapna, Sushupti. But they are not continuously there. That is why they are mithya. They belong to three bodies. Therefore, three bodies are mithya. Who is that I am? I am conscious of waking state. I am conscious of dream state. I am conscious of sleep state. I am conscious of my childhood. I am conscious of my youth. I am conscious of my old age. What I am conscious of is not me. I am conscious is me. What I am conscious of, avasthas, not me. That is Vesham. Who I am conscious of, I am awareness, is my real nature. That is I am. Vyavruttasu anuvartamanam aham iti antaspurantam. Where this I thought comes? Antaha spurantam. When? Sada, all the time. Boyhood, youthhood, old age, jagrat, waking state, I am. Dream state also, I am. Sleep state also, I am. I am, I am, I am, I am. Sada spurantam. That spuranam is called consciousness. I am conscious of, I am conscious of. The amness is existence, I am. That consciousness, I, awareness. Are you conscious being or unconscious being? Conscious being. With an incidental body-mind avasthas and body-mind complex. Don't take this body-mind complex as yourself. Who teaches? Hatraya mudrayaya prakati karoti yaha saha dakshinamurti tasmai my salutations. What he reveals, Swatmanam, his own real nature. What is that? Satchit. How he reveals? As my real nature. He reveals. So Dakshinamurti is also Satchit. I am also Satchit. My fatherhood, brotherhood, sisterhood are my coat. Temporary vesham. After chapel you wear and you go. As a mother, father, whatever relation you want. But in class, while you are listening, you are claiming, you are Brahman, Ahamasmi. Ahamasmi Brahma, Ahamasmi. With an incidental name and form, they cannot touch me, disturb me. Enough? Enough of this shloka? Do meditation. Repeat the same shloka continuously, hundreds and hundreds of times. With the meaning, you can claim Aham Brahma Asmi. Simple. Next verse. Together. Eighth verse.
Vishvam Pashyati Karya Karyakataya Swaswami Sambandhata Sishya Acharya Taya Tathaiva Pitru Putra Dhyatmana Vedata Swapne Jagrati Vahya Desha Purusho
Another important idea Shankaracharya is presenting. The same Satchit Ananda Swarupam Brahman Aham is in the form of Dakshinamurti form also, Jivatma form also, the individual. Not only that, I relate, I the Satchit am relating with what are all relations. Vishvam Pashyati, seeing the world. I the Jivatma, now seeing the world. How Karya Karanataya, cause and effect relationship. My father, mother, they both were the cause. I am the effect. Correct? I am the product. They are the cause. I am the karyam. They are the karanam. Correct? Karya karanataya vishvam pasyati. I am karyam. My parents are the cause of me. Karya karana sambandha. Am I karyam only? No. I am karanam from my children's standpoint. Correct? My children are products. They are products only. From their standpoint, I am the father, mother is karanam. So from my father's standpoint, I am karyam, a product. From my children's standpoint, I am karanam, my children are products. So karya karana sambandha vishvam pasyati. I look at the world in this manner. Karya karana taya. What are the karya karanas? He gives some example. Sva swami sambandhataha. Sva means I am a vrityaha. Bhagavan is swami. Sva swami sambandha. You can take bhakta, bhakta and swami sambandha. Or you can take swa means own possession, wealth. This is my possession and this is my house. I am the owner of this house. I created this house. I am the karta, karanam. This house is my product. I am the swami of this house. All are serving to me, sevakas. Like that, so many relations. You can see that way. Vritya Swami Sambandha. Sva Swami Sambandhataha. Then Sishya Acharya Sambandhataha. I am a Sishya, and he is my guru, she is my guru. So sambandha, shishya acharya sambandha, sambandha dvikotikah. So my guru is there, therefore I am shishya. Shishya guru sambandha, acharya sambandha. This guru is a guru all the time. He was a shishya. So shishya and that guru says, my guru is, I am having relation with my guru, I am associated with my guru, guru shishya sambandha. See, once guru shishya sambandha, shishya acharya sambandha. Then next one, tatha eva pitu pituhu putra sambandha. My father and son, father son relation. This son becomes tomorrow father, and that son becomes again father. Pitu putra sambandha atmana bhedatah. Pitru putra di adi padat, other relations you get. Atmana sambandhatah, I am related to this person, to this relation, this relation, this relation. All these relations are real. Really speaking, they are not real. Then what are they? We'll see that in the next class. Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah.